everybody. Thanks for stopping by my YouTube channel. Today we're going to be doing a Steve Good project. We're going to be doing this Bible and cross, the Word of God right here. I did this one last week. I'm going to do another one today with you. So these are fun to make and very easy to make, and you can get the patterns off Steve's blog, Scrollsaw Workshop. blogspot.com, and I'll put the link below. Make sure you hit my subscribe button, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up for the video. I got a lot more videos coming in the future. So with that all said, we're gonna go ahead and start working on this here project. I already got the blue tape and my pattern and clear packaging tape on my lumber. Now this is quarter inch Baltic birch, so that's what we'll be using today. And what's nice about this project here, it's a layered project. It's actually got three different layers. Each layer is a quarter inch, so it is only one size of lumber you need. So I have the pattern on all three pieces of wood here. You got the pattern right here. So, and it does have some inside cutting we're gonna have to do, this Jesus and then the words right here. So we're gonna head over to the drill press and get them drilled out. Okay, I'm at the drill press here. I got a, I believe it's a 3/32 drill bit in here. You wanna make sure when you drill your holes for any of your scroll saw projects that you have a small enough drill bit to fit in the area you need to drill out and not drill outside that area. But you also have to remember to make sure the hole's big enough for the blade of your scroll saw to go through, and in most cases it will, but you just have to make sure the hole will be big enough for your blade of your scroll saw to fit through, so you can thread it through. So we'll get these holes drilled. Okay, hole's all drilled. I'm gonna head over to the scroll saw and get this working on. Okay, at the scroll saw here, what I like to do, this particular project's got three layers, and this is the backing of the layer. Everything gets layered on top of this, so we're gonna cut the backing out first. I have a number three reverse tooth blade, Pegasus blade in here. It seems to work real good, number three with quarter inch. So we'll get started here. Okay, for the actual part that's got the inside cuts, I like to do the inside cuts first before I actually cut the project out. It just gives you more to hang on to. Okay, I see, I forgot to drill a hole right here for this inside cut, but I'm going to cut this out, and then I'm going to drill that hole and do that. Okay, so we got that all cut out. Just got this last area right here. I'm going to drill that hole, cut that off camera, and we'll go back to the workbench and get this sanded up. All right, we're at the bench here. One thing nice about using this blue tape is the pattern comes off really nice. So that's the advantage of using that blue tape. Then we just gotta take the blue tape off, which comes off pretty nice. And it, plus it doesn't leave no sticky residue on there. So we just get this tape off. And that works out pretty nice. That blue tape is nice when you got small intricate work like that, you don't have to worry about breaking anything. Okay, and then you have to make sure you got all the tape off the back. Okay, and the back of this. Okay, so all the tape's off. We're gonna sand this up. Start with this cross right here. I got 220 on here, and this is a piece of 220 right here. Just gonna do the surfaces back and front. Do the edges, soften up all the edges on these. So that's what you want to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the camera off, do all this sanding on here, and we will be right back. Okay, we have everything sanded here. You want to soften up all the edges, get all the fuzzies out from the words here. Just go around it with some 220 sandpaper, soften it up. Looks pretty nice. So we're going to stain this. What I do is on the one I made already, this is dark walnut stain, and then I just put a boiled linseed oil over the top of everything once it's all glued together. So we're just going to stain the back, this backing piece, and the cross that goes on top, the other piece right here. And this is just a dark walnut stain. You could probably glue this together and just leave it all natural too, just put an oil on it. I like the two-tone look. So I'm gonna do the rest of this staining off camera, get everything all dried and glued together. and then I'll be back here with the finished product. Okay, so I let the stain dry overnight, and then what I did was took the three different layers for this project and glued them together. I did not put the oil on this one, and you can see the one that I did a week or so back, that's got the oil on it, so you might maybe can see a difference between the two in color. I did not put the oil on this one. You could put a spray on it, oil on it, any color, a stain you'd like. I used a dark walnut stain for that one. And then on most of my Scrollsaw projects, I use boiled linseed oil on most of my projects. It really brings out the grain, especially on your darker wood. So this pattern, again, you can get from scrollsawworkshop.blogspot.com. That's Steve Good. He's got hundreds and hundreds of patterns that you can download. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up if you like this video. And also, make any comments down below if you'd like. I will answer the comments. And till next time then, work safe, and main thing is have fun.